Hello everyone, in this tutorial I will run you through the process of creating what is, in my opinion, one of the most difficult and rewarding structures in a 3D space, the eternally elusive palm of the hand. Now, this is very important as an exercise as it will familiarize you with the object hierarchy, links and rigging inside Neobarok. I will do my best to employ all of the techniques that I've gone through in my previous tutorials, so in terms of modeling, you should be familiar with the process. If not, I suggest that you give the tutorials a quick check because I will not be doing a live commentary in this one. This tutorial is really important because it will illustrate the enormous benefit that Neobarok has in comparison to other present-day software, such as ZBrush. I know that sounds bold, but trust me, I have been made as an artist by that software and I'm still very much in love with it. But not enough to deny what a brilliant new workflow Neobarok brings to the table. And it all boils down to the ability to rig your object while modeling it by being mindful of its construction. So start with the center of mass, in this case the palm, or for a humanoid character, the pelvic area, and work your way down to the tip of the fingers. This in the end will provide you with a healthy hierarchy that is anatomically correct and that will allow you to pose your object freely the moment the modeling stage has ended. And believe me, this is one of the most amazing sensations that you can experience in a CGI environment. Thank you. The next tutorial is going to be a full character, and I will do my best to take you through the whole process with commentaries on the most important parts, the most crucial parts, and that will probably be the end of this tutorial series. I think that you will have been taken through most likely every scenario that you will be facing in Neobarok as a character artist or as somebody that's really interested in modeling. There are certain things and aspects of Neobarok that I haven't gone through. There are parts of Neobarok that I haven't showed yet, like hydraulics and cables, but that is something that I will leave to you to explore and to have fun with. And I think I will make one more tutorial to explore jewel crafting inside Neobarok, which I think is going to be quite exciting. So stick around. I hope you enjoyed, and the next tutorial is going to be out probably next Friday. So stay tuned. Happy modeling. Till next time.